Clostridium difficile, morphology. This one is a gram positive rod, four former, obligate anaerobic organism, motile also. We can see this organism endogenous inside gastrointestinal tract of many individual. We can see this organism in gastrointestinal tract of many individual. Normally this organism will be inhibited by other bacterial organism inside gastrointestinal tract, but by using antibiotic other normal flora will destroyed, and this organism, because of it is spore former, it will change into spores. When this antibiotic are stopped, this organism will change into vegetative form. After that only it will causes infection. Normally this one is spore forming. When we are stopping taking antibiotic, then it will change into vegetative form. After that only it will causes infection. Then it causes antibiotic associated diarrhea. Due to nosocomial infection, it also causes exogenous infection also. This one is a gram positive rod, four forming organism, obligate anaerobic motile organism. This one normally presented in gastrointestinal tract of many individual. When we are stopping this antibiotic, this spore forming will change to vegetative form. After that only it will causes infection, that are antibiotic associated diarrhea. Then it will causes exogenous infection also, majority because of hospital. Then virulence factor, it will produce two different type of toxin, exotoxin A and exotoxin B. Exotoxin A, it is a protein that damage the intestinal mucosa. It attack PMN and causes them to degranulate, resulting in more damage and necrotized tissue formation in intestinal area. Exogenous A is a protein that damage intestinal mucosa, then it attract PMN and causes them to degranulate, resulting more damage and necrotized tissue formation in intestinal area. Exotoxin B, it is a AB type of toxin that disturb the cytokladen of enterocytes. Exotoxin B, it is a AB type of toxin that one will disturb the cytokladen of enterocytes. Fragment A get inside with the help of host cell protease. Mechanism of damage is unknown. This AB toxin will disturb that cytokladen. This mechanism was unknown. Then epidemiology, this one is endogenous, but US not in endogenous. Other part, it presented in gastrointestinal tract. It mainly caused by nosocomial infection, prolonged use of antibiotics. Elder are at greatest risk. It mainly affected oldest people, gastrointestinal surgery, serious underlying illness, and immunocompromised patient. This one is endogenous, not in US. Other part only endogenous. It causes nosocomial infection also. Then it causes serious infection in gastrointestinal surgery, serious underlying illness, and immunocompromised risk. Then pathogenesis. Usage of antibiotic can diminish normal flora of gastrointestinal tract. This Clostridium difficile is spore forming in nature, can resistant to antibiotic. After antibiotic therapy, the vegetative form will produce the toxin. Previously this one is spore forming in nature. After that it will change into the vegetative form. Then only it will produce the toxin. Then it leads to diarrhea and pseudomembrane enterocolitis. Then it causes antibiotic associated diarrhea. Pathogenesis. Usage of antibiotic can diminish normal flora of gastrointestinal tract. this one is pore forming in nature. After that, it change into vegetative form. After that only it will produce a taxin, then it causes diarrhea. Then clinical feature, it causes diarrhea, nausea, vomiting, blood in stool, fever, leukocytosis. In clinical feature, it causes diarrhea, nausea, vomiting, blood in stool, fever, leukocytosis. In prolonged cases, it causes pseudomembrane enterocolitis due to B taxin. Then it can destroy the cell, leads to death. Diagnosis, we are using stool taxin test, ELISA. By using ELISA, we finding antibodies. Then gas liquid chromatography also we are using. This one absurd organism. Diagnosis, stool taxin test, ELISA, gas liquid chromatography. Treatment has highly relapse rate. Discontinue broad spectrum antibiotic therapy, replace loss folate and electrolytes. Vancomycin and metronidazole are used for treatment of Clostridium tepsili. So treatment is highly relapse rate, discontinued broad spectrum antibiotic therapy, replaced loss of folate and electrolytes. We are taking vancomycin and metronidazole is used when necessary. That's all about Clostridium tepsili.